Today, we're going to tackle one of the most common questions that comes up when families decide to homeschool.
How will you socialize your kids?
Welcome to Kids Learning for Life. That's Jenny.
That's Stacy.
And we're two homeschooling moms. We're here to help families teach kids the joy of learning.
Because learning doesn't happen just during school, it happens throughout life.
It seems like a popular argument against homeschooling that people may have is that children will be unable to make friends or navigate social situations. But this is just not the case.
It's completely understandable for people who came from the regular school system, like ourselves, to have trouble envisioning what this could look like for kids who don't physically go to school.
Socialization was one of my main concerns before I started a homeschool, but then I started to think about what socialization looks like in everyday life. Think about what you do in a typical day. Are you stuck in one room with 25 other people who are exactly the same age as you, and you're all working on the exact same projects? Well, this is what's happening in a regular school setting. Students are divided by age, and then based on their age, it determines what they will learn and when they will learn it.
There are good reasons why schools are set up this way, but it doesn't necessarily set kids up for practical socialization skills for when they leave out into the real world. In everyday life, we socialize with people of all ages in a variety of different settings.
When homeschooling, there will be times where it's just you and your children at home, and this is the perfect time to teach fundamental social skills to your children. This will prepare them for when they encounter social situations in everyday life.
Socialization outside the home does require the parent to take a more active role in finding ways to socialize your kids. Here are some examples of how you can find socialization opportunities for your kids.
When you're new to homeschooling, it can sometimes feel isolating depending on how much support you have from family and friends. If you don't know any other homeschooling families, it can be helpful to find and join a local homeschooling group in your area. You can use websites like Facebook and Meetup to help you find a local homeschool group in your area. If you can't find one in your area, try creating one, or try to expand your search to include other towns or cities around you. These groups are great places to let your children socialize and allow you to also get some great homeschooling advice and tips from other homeschool parents just like you. Most groups meet in free or public places and can be free to join or have a small yearly fee.
Another option for socialization is in-person classes and co-ops. You can find classes in a variety of subjects for your kids to take at local educational businesses. These classes meet roughly once a week, but sometimes you can find ones that meet more often. You can find classes in a variety of different subjects for your kids to take at local educational businesses. Sometimes these classes meet once a week, or you can even find ones that meet more often. This is a great option if you want to primarily homeschool your children, but do want them to be surrounded by peers when learning and also get taught by another adult from time to time. Classes vary in price based on your area and the materials used, but in my experience, classes aim to be as affordable as possible. Another cheaper option can be homeschool co-ops. This is where a group of parents get together and choose to teach different subjects to one group of kids together. One parent might teach a foreign language, one parent might teach math, and another might teach a musical instrument. You can connect with families by networking with people you know, or finding groups online, like Stacy just mentioned.
Finding hobbies and clubs for your children can be a great way to encourage group learning. These activities, such as swim lessons, gymnastics, 4-H, and many others, are more recreational in nature, and they provide your child an opportunity to explore their hobbies as well as meet other children that share their same interests. Family participation and cost are going to vary widely from activity to activity, so you're going to want to keep that in mind when you're looking for new hobbies. Extracurricular activities can be beneficial to foster confidence in children, as well as teach them practical life skills.
Another way to get kids out and about is to visit popular public places. This includes parks, libraries, zoos, and museums, but the opportunities are endless. It might be important to you to let your kids meet others organically in a natural setting, and this is the best way to do that. It's fun to see kids navigate social situations on their own and make new friends, and even learn skills like sharing and listening to others. Outings like these can be affordable or even free, and are fun for the whole family.
It's also important to look inward at your own family unit for socialization. Chances are, if you're choosing to homeschool, you probably value quality family time and want to instill these values in your children. Within the family, children can learn important life lessons, such as selflessness when demonstrated by their parents, or conflict resolution skills when they're solving a dispute between themselves and their siblings. This learning is done within the safety of the home, where love and support are readily given. This kind of socialization should not be discounted, because it provides a crucial foundation for socialization outside of the home.
Lastly, don't hesitate to take your kids on errands or experience remedial tasks with you. It's through these everyday life experiences that kids learn skills that will benefit them for life. As much as we change our routines to fit our children's desires, we should also make sure that they're exposed to tasks like depositing money at the bank, or sitting in line patiently at the DMV, or interacting with adults that you encounter in public, just to name a few. They're still under your guidance and can be taught valuable lessons about how the world works outside of the classroom.
I think we can all agree that learning to socialize is an important part of growing up. When homeschooling, finding socialization options for your kids may take more effort on the part of the parent, but it doesn't have to be as hard as some people make it out to be.
We hope these ideas were helpful to you. If you have any fun new ideas on how to socialize your kids, let us know in the comments below.
If you like this video, be sure to like and subscribe to get more homeschooling content just like this.
Also, be sure to download our free How to Start Homeschooling Note Guide linked in the description below and on our website at kidslearningforlife.com.
See you next time!